Channel 5 serving the best place on earth. Now, Eyewitness News is everywhere.
And it promises better results than the traditional facelift. We're going to tell you how the vertical lift works. Well, coming up next, it's a new surgical technique that is growing in popularity. We'll tell you why the vertical facelift is gaining fans. Tonight on 5 Reports, a technique that is changing the way that cosmetic surgeons perform facelifts. It's called a vertical lift, and as Barbara Rogers discovered, the results are more than skin deep.
Susan Baltzer knew two things about herself. She didn't like the way she looked, and she didn't want a traditional facelift.
I didn't want to look like an alien when I was done, and I've seen a lot of people that look like that.
Susan's classic requests were for correction of the nasolabial fold.
Susan turned to San Francisco surgeon Michael Kuhn for a procedure that's growing in popularity, the vertical facelift. Here's how it works. Instead of tightening the face by pulling the skin back, surgeons use a laser underneath the skin to separate the tissue and reposition it further up on the face.
Instead of pulling on the skin and having that counter pull, I basically tack up beneath the skin and then just redrape it. There's really no tension.
Kulik says the technique avoids the severe, over-tightened look many facelifts have, where a patient's eyes can appear bigger and their lips stretched. And remember Susan's complaint, the hanging jowls? This is Susan before, this is Susan after.
The fat that's at the corner of the mouth, the jowl area, I move up and I place back over the cheekbone.
With traditional techniques, patients sometimes experience severe bruising, like the woman in this photograph, because of small blood vessels broken during surgery.
With the laser, you don't have that, because as you're cutting, you're also sealing off all the blood vessels.
And begin isn't being used to pull back the patient's face. Surgeons are able to make smaller incisions around the scalp without moving the hairline.
Right here in the hairline, so all I have to do is pull a little bit of my hair down.
Despite the before and after advantages, surgeons do admit that even vertical facelifts don't last forever, and patients will eventually need touch-ups down the road, a potentially expensive proposition for some. Still, men and women who want to mask the effects of aging with fewer side effects may decide the vertical facelift has advantages far beyond face value. In San Francisco, Barbara Rogers for 5 Reports.